In this section, we're going to combine what we've learned about two-dimensional and three-dimensional vectors together and do some more involved and upper-level applications of those vectors. Okay, so the first way that we deal with vectors is velocity. So we treat vectors as velocity. Now, it is common for two or more velocities to combine together to make the final velocity for an object. For example, a boat can have a velocity from its motor, but then also there's current in the water. Similarly, an airplane has the velocity given to it by its engines, but it also has crosswinds and headwinds and tailwinds, right? A man can walk on the cruise ship. He's got velocity from his legs, but the ship itself has velocity. Right? Think of it in planetary motion. We exist on the planet, but the planet is moving. So we have a velocity where we are based on relative to us, but then there's also a velocity of the planet moving around. Okay, now what would the velocity be for a person that is running on a treadmill, and why? Well, the answer to that is a little deceptive, but it's zero, right? So what's happening is the person is going one way, right? So this is the person. And the treadmill has to go the opposite way. And they have to match, or the person falls off the treadmill, and that can be dangerous. So if the person's moving at velocity v, the treadmill has to move negative v. And that's why on the treadmill itself, overall, you have a velocity of zero. You don't go anywhere. You run in place for hours or minutes, and you don't actually move any particular location. Now, and in general, it is true that the velocity of an object relative to a stationary point is equal to the sum of the other velocity vectors. So we use vg, v the velocity, g ground, g for ground, to find the velocity with respect to the ground. Or stationary point. And vg is the sum of all the component velocity vectors that make it up, right? All the contributing velocities. Okay, so let's see an example. We have a boat that's traveling due east at 20 miles per hour relative to the water in a river with a northeast current of 4 miles per hour. We're going to find the velocity, direction, and speed. Okay, so let's draw a picture here. And this is two-dimensional right now, right? This boat isn't flying in the air, right? This is a boat, it's in the water. So this is a 2D problem, as opposed to an airplane, which will be a 3D problem, okay? So we have north right here, which is the positive y-axis, and we have x right here, which is east. The positive x-axis is east. Okay, now the person, or the boat, is traveling east at 20 miles per hour, which is this way. So that the velocity of the boat is 20, or excuse me, the magnitude of the velocity is 20. The velocity for the boat, because it's due east, would be 20 in the x direction and 0 in the y direction, right? Because it's due east. All right. But there's a current, a cross current. Let me do it. I have to find a green pen here. Let's see here. Let's do this one. So the cross current is northeast, right? So that would be a 45 degree angle like that. And it's not nearly as long. I shouldn't draw it so long because it's only a magnitude of 4. I'll exaggerate it a little bit. There we go. So that has a magnitude of 4. And that's the northeast direction. So the velocity for the current, C for current. Okay, well, remember that angle in there is 45 degrees. So this angle right here is 45 degrees. And so the velocity for the current, we learned how to do that. That is the magnitude 4 times the cosine of the angle, and the magnitude 4 times the sine of the angle. And these are ones we don't even need to look up in Desmos. We know what these are, right? This is 4 times the square root of 2 over 2, and 4 times the square root of 2 over 2, which would make it 2 square root of 2, 2 square root of 2. So then, the combined velocity, the velocity with respect to a stationary point. So the boat is putting its engines at 20 miles per hour, but the current is pushing it, right? So the velocity to the ground is putting those two together. And so it would be the velocity from the boat plus the velocity from the current. And that would be 20, 0 plus 2 squared of 2, 2 squared of 2. All right, lovely. So this will be 20 plus 2 squared of 2, and then 2 squared of 2. And that's all well and good, but it's kind of weird. So let's find some decimal approximations for those so that we have a better sense of it. And again, I'm just going to use Desmos, but you could use Maple. It's no biggie. You just have to make sure you convert to degrees, to mean to radians, because Maple doesn't like degrees. So 20, although in this case I don't have to do any of that, 20 plus 2 square root of 2, and then 2 square root of 2. Although I knew what that was. So that is 22.828 and 2.828. All right, so there's the velocity with respect to the current. So we found that. So velocity, or speed with respect to the ground. There's that piece answered. Direction and speed. Well, speed is actually really easy to find. Speed is just the magnitude of the velocity. So speed is the magnitude of that velocity. So it's the square root of 22.828 squared plus 2.828 squared. And we can just make Desmos find that without any difficulty. So we can say, find the square root of this value squared plus this value. There we go. And we get about 23. Okay, so this is about 23, and that would be miles per hour. Oh, and so is this. These are both miles per hour because they're velocity. Okay, now what about the direction? Okay, well, the direction is the trickiest bit because you have to find the angle. So the tangent of theta is equal to 2.83 divided by, right, the y divided by the x, 22.828, or 828, I should say. There we go. Right, so the tangent of theta is the y divided by the x. We learned that back in the day, the v2 divided by v1. Okay, so theta is the arc tangent of that value, 2.828 over 22.828, sort of. Right, so we have to double check that it'll work, but in this case, we happen to know we're in quadrant 1, so it'll be fine. If it was in quadrant 2 or 3 or 4, we might run into issues. But arctangent finds quadrant 1, no problem. So again, let me grab Desmos. Let me just ask it. Find me the arctangent of, and it's this value, divided by this value. Again, I could have named those, but it's fine. So it's 7.06 degrees. So 7 degrees, if you will, if we're rounding. Okay, so my direction, and you can see it in the graph, right? If you think about how we graph, right? You would tack on that 4 degrees over here at the end of this vector. And so we're actually going out this way. That's VG, right? It takes the boat, adds the current, and you end up over there. And it's a slim angle. It's not very steep. So the direction is 7 degrees north of due east.